The NHL season is underway, and we have a great matchup between two Original Six teams with the Boston Bruins and the New York Rangers. Let's go to the highlights.
All right, then. The Rangers are riding a two-game winning streak from this weekend and are looking to make it three games here. Picking up play late in the first period as Boston is on the attack, and here's Austin Zarnik, and the puck goes right past Lundqvist as the Bruins take a 2-0 lead off of Zarnik's first NHL goal. A bright start for this young player's career. But the Rangers would not take this lead sitting down, as here in the second period, Brandon Peary would score on the power play and give the Rangers a 3-2 lead. But this wouldn't stop here, as Mark Stahl will go wide, but who is it but Brandon Peary would follow through and give him a 4-2 lead. And they're not done yet. So Rick Nash would pass to Jimmy Vesey, and he would put it in for a 5-2 score. As the Rangers would score five unanswered goals for the win.
Now, guys, let's break the game down. Rangers offense has been on fire. They scored four unanswered against the Capitals to win there, and five here as well. What does this say about the team?
It says the offense is clicking. That first line of Vesey, Nash, and Stepan are really, really doing well. Second line is clicking. They're making their passes that they need to do, and they're scoring goals, which is what they've been paid, which is what they were trying to do right from the start.
Joe, what do you think?
Yeah, I got to agree with Ricky on this one. The top line of VZ, Stepan, Nash has been outstanding. Nash is finally healthy this year, and he's finally showing his elite goal-scoring status among the NHL. The second line's really there. They haven't missed a beat with Brassard getting shipped out to Ottawa, with Zibanejad plugging in right into that second line spot. Offense, the depth scoring has been great, and the defense has been solid so far, and Lundqvist has looked sharp too. So
yeah, I mean, I guess we're all in agreement here. That first line has been great, especially Rick Nash, who has 5 points in seven games this year. Mm. And the team as a whole has 27 goals in seven games. That's leading the league. That's
right.
Almost four goals a game.
Yeah.
So they've been great, but I think the Bruins have figured them out a little bit before the Bruins start killing themselves with penalties. They really eliminated those outlet lanes from D to O transition, defense to offense transition of the Rangers, and they were shutting them down for a period, and then they started killing themselves in the second and third period.
Yeah, that first period is what I don't want to talk about.
Of course, as a Rangers fan. Now, a Rangers-Bruins game is always going to be interesting, to say the least. We saw Dan Girardi leave the game after a bit of a controversial hit by David Pastrnak, which broke right before the show, was suspended for two games due to that hit. What do we think about that?
Yeah, let's take a look at that hit right here with this replay. As you see, Dan Girardi is going up for the puck, and Pastrnak goes up for the headshot, knocking down Dan Girardi. So the Department of Player Safety said that was called an illegal hit to the head, which is not allowed in the NHL, and he was then given two-game suspension.
I think that's ridiculous, honestly. I don't think he should have been suspended two games for this. I think maybe a fine because of the hit to the head. You can't be hitting anyone defenseless in the head. It's like in the NFL, there's targeting. Like, a guy will get kicked out of the game for that. Mm-hmm. But he didn't leave his feet until after he hit him. If you look at the replay there, his feet didn't leave the ice until after he hit Dan Girardi there. His left foot was still on the ice. So in my mind, it was somewhat of a clean hit, even though he did hit a defenseless player.
Even though I believe that his feet did leave the ice, we're in disagreement there, the Department of Player Safety said it was the whole hit to the head, the fact that he leaned up and Girardi's head was not moving anywhere. It was in the same position when he was reaching up for the goal puck and then coming down,
Does that constitute a two-game suspension? Does the league have any protocol that says a two-game suspension for a hit to the head? I thought it was leaving the feet would be a two-game suspension.
And this is where the Department of Player Safety has some issues. It's by a case-by-case basis.
Right.
So Pastrnak has no history of suspension or fines. Girardi was not injured. So for some reason, they determined that two games was fine. I think it's a little much. I thought one game would have been more than enough, but they deemed two games was enough. I think they're trying to use this as a reasoning to the rest of the league, saying, don't do this or you're going to get fined.
Riggy, I got to agree with you there. They did say that Pastrnak doesn't have history of being a dirty player. Girardi wasn't injured on the play. But instead of giving two games, I think I would have just given him a fine. If you see the video, his left skate's still on the ice when he delivers the hit.
Exactly.
And you can hit players in the head. It's not like you're blindsiding them and he's not getting a whiplash or anything like that. you know, shoulder to head, no problems with that. He didn't throw an elbow, anything like that. Mm-hmm. To me, it was a clean hit, and I think I would have just fined him at the very max.
Yeah, I think the two-game suspension, I think, was absolutely ridiculous. But, you know, we're still early in the season. Right. Pasternak will use it as a learning experience.
Now, let's move on to penalties. A lot of them in this game. Problem for the Bruins. They were called for 7 infractions on the night. How do they fix this moving forward? Because you can't be productive when you're always ended up in the box.
Exactly. You have to. They have to learn. A lot of these penalties were just simple mistakes. You know, hitting a player when he doesn't have the puck, that's an interference. You can't do that. It was really rookie mistakes, and a lot of the rookie players were the ones who were called for these penalties, and they paid for it. The Rangers scored twice on the power play, so that's the big thing. They have to practice.
Oh yeah, the Bruins, they have a lot of veterans in the top six. They got guys like Bergeron, Backes, Krejci. The bottom six, however, it shifts towards the younger side in the league. Sure. A lot of inexperienced guys. They're not as disciplined as the veterans. Yeah. You know, the good thing with the Bruins, they do have some good penalty killers, right, but they're just going to have to get a little bit more disciplined, stay out of the box.
Now, gentlemen, we're going to break down. We had a lot of exciting action around the NHL, and we're going to throw it to Mike with his top five plays of the week.
All right, so here are the top five plays of the week. Number five right here is Anaheim versus Nashville. As you see, a tick, attack, and a toe backhand goal. That would be the first goal for Anaheim on the power play. Anaheim would end up winning that game 6-1 against a powerful Nashville team. Really, I was watching that game. It was a blowout for them. Number four right here, we have Tampa Bay versus Toronto. As you see the back pass, and who's there? But it is Stamkos, and he gets the dribbler right past for the goal. Number three, so you see your overtime, San Jose versus Anaheim. As you see, San Jose winning the game in overtime as Vlasic would score the game-winning goal. Happy, happy they are winning in overtime. Number two coming up, we have Philadelphia versus Buffalo power play. As you see, a scramble in front of the net for Philly, and Philly gets the goal to tie the game with less than 2 minutes to go. Philadelphia would end up winning in a shootout. Let's take a look at that again. 1, 2, 3, many shots on net, and finally one gets in via Street. Massive play there for them. And your number one play of the week, Chicago versus Philly. 5 seconds left, 5, 4, so many, 3 saves there, and now and the Flames would end up winning in shootout. So that was your game-winning save.
Definitely an exciting week for the NHL, and that's all the time we have for hockey. Thank you for tuning in to WP Sports Desk. Catch us same time, same place next week. As always, thank you to our producers, our analysts, and our studio manager, Al Clark. From Studio B in Hobart Hall, I'm Mason Mills. I'll see you next week.